really special for you. We are going to make homemade pasta, just like grandma used to do it, remember? And here is cousin Kathy from Italy, and here is cousin Vito from Italy, and we're gonna show you exactly how to make this pasta. But I'm gonna tell you the most exciting thing. We are bringing this pasta to you from our house. Yes, and it's coming soon. We're gonna be selling it, and it's called Busiate. But today, we wanna do something special. We wanna show you how to make them. So let's go ahead and get started. So here, cousin Kathy, tell us, what do we have to do?
Oggi facciamo le busiate trapanesi. Gli ingredienti che utilizzeremo sono molto semplici.
We're gonna make the busiate trapanese, and the ingredients we have to use are very simple.
Semolina di grano duro.
We're gonna use semolina.
Acqua.
We're gonna use water.
E un po' di olio.
E un po' di papa beans, extra virgin olive oil. Okay. So she went ahead and put some water here in the center. That's right. Just a little bit. We already have put it before, and she's gonna start mixing. That's right. And she's gonna put a little bit of oil too. Perfect. So we're gonna mix the water little by little. Dobbiamo mischiare poco a poco l'acqua con la semolina, vero?
Sì.
Fino a che consistenza?
Una consistenza un po' dura.
Until it has a kind of a hard consistency, okay? Mm-hmm. How much, quanta semolina abbiamo messo qua? L'hai misurato?
Abbiamo messo 800 grammi di semolina.
We put about 800 grams of semolina.
Acqua quanto basta.
And water, we just have to use whatever is necessary.
E un po' d'olio.
And obviously, a little bit of oil. And then you start working the dough just the, you know, the way Kathy is working it. Now, dimmi Kathy, come sai che è pronta?
Perché ormai abbiamo amalgamato tutta la farina, impastato tutta la farina.
She knows that it's ready because we have already used all the flour.
È abbastanza compatta.
Is compacted.
Da poter fare ora le foglie.
So now we can make, you know, the sheets, that way we can cut the pasta.
Okay, ora che la pasta è pronta.
Now that the flour is ready, or the dough is ready, I should say, we're just gonna cut it.
La taglio a pezzetti.
We're gonna cut little pieces.
E la stendiamo col mattarello.
And we're gonna extend it with a mattarello. And I want you to notice how this flour, and it's not flour, okay? This is semolina, because the flour is more like a powder, but the semolina is more like a sand grains. And I want you to notice that this is how pasta is actually made, and this is very important, and the reason is a little bit, it's not as thin as powder, it's more like grains in the sand, is because it has a bunch of proteins, it has fiber, and it has vitamins. I mean, it has all the nutrients that you need, that your body needs to be healthy. And that's why we're so excited to bring to you this type of pasta instead of the other pasta that the big companies are making.
E che stai facendo ora? What are you doing now? Sta facendo le quadrette. She's making it square.
Giusto per il video, che metto tutta.
She's pulling a little bit, spreading a little bit of semolina. La sta girando.
Così possiamo avere due tipi di pasta, le tagliatelle
This way we can make two types of pasta. Tagliatelle.
E utilizzando questo.
And using this little stick.
Abbiamo la busiata.
There it is! Busiata!
Bettina, questo è il nome della busiata?
This name of the busiata?
Nasce.
Comes.
Questo stecchino in dialetto siciliano.
The name of this little stick in Sicilian dialect.
Si chiama busa.
Busa.
Ecco perché la pasta è busiata.
And this is why the pasta is called busiata, because this little stick is called busa. And this is how grandmother used to make her pasta. Isn't that exciting? The thing I want to tell you about it is, why do we make this macaroni like this? You know, that we roll them. And there is a reason for that.
Perché? Perché se è un ricciolo.
Because if it's rolled like that.
Quando
curly.
Quando si mette il sugo di pomodoro.
When you use the tomato sauce.
Il maccherone prende più sugo di pomodoro.
The macaroni retains the juice from the tomato sauce.
Ecco, così è anche, come dire, più gustoso perché c'è più sugo.
It makes eating the macaroni more tasteful because it's full of tomato sauce right inside. That's why, you know, we love the shape. The other thing that we want to talk about is, I want you to notice how this grain is yellow in comparison with the white grain in flour. And you wonder why this is yellow. The reason is because it's not pressed until it becomes powder. Actually, you know, it's just pressed with a stone, and we just want to make sure, you know, that we leave in it the vitamins, the proteins, the fibers, and what happens is those are the colors, those are the colors of the ingredients of the grain, and that's why this grain is still yellow. Instead, when you look at your flour, usually it's on the white side, and that's why, because they press it so fine that it takes away the vitamins, the proteins, the fibers, and then the color, which is the natural color of the grain, leaves the flour. And isn't that exciting? We're making pasta with a flour that is full of nutrients. Great. Did you enjoy the video?
My name is Bettina Feo, and my family has been making extra virgin olive oil since 1935. In March of 2013, we decided that it was time to bless you with the same extra virgin olive oil my family has been enjoying for years.
If you have never tasted any of our products, I challenge you today to do so. There is a special offer. You're gonna see it popping up here on the screen, or you're gonna see a link in the bottom of the screen. Just take advantage of our offer. And then the other thing that I challenge you today is to please taste Papa Vince extra virgin olive oil. For 99 cents, you can learn what's the real taste of the real extra virgin olive oil, and you can help us fight fraud in the industry of extra virgin olive oil. So I challenge you today to get your 99 cent sample. And thank you very much, and I'm so glad you enjoyed the video.